All right, here we are. I'm Judson Reid of the Cornell Vegetable Program. I'm here at one of our cooperating high tunnel greenhouses where we're doing some research on cover crops. And you can see here behind me how much biomass we've created with this cover crop. The concept here is by growing this, we can grow some of our own nitrogen in the wintertime when normally these wouldn't have any crops growing in them. And this way we can reduce our fertilizer inputs once we're up and growing, say, a fruiting vegetable crop like tomatoes. So what we're trying to do is look at different combinations of cover crops, different timings, and different ways to manage it. Boy, this looks beautiful. So behind me, you can see one of our cover crop treatments. This is a combination of triticale and a legume called Austrian winter peas or field peas. And those winter peas, what they can do is fix nitrogen from the atmosphere and add it to the soil. This triticale is a grain, what we call a winter grain. It does a fantastic job of scavenging nitrogen that's in the ground and then putting it into this vegetative form. And then this, over time, is our slow release fertilizer for the vegetable crops that we grow during the warm season. So what our cooperating farmer here intends to do is take all of this cover crop that you see behind me, and he's going to incorporate that with a tiller into the soil a couple weeks before he transplants tomatoes. What we're trying to do is really see, can we improve our nutrient management here by growing and capturing some of our own nitrogen in this cover crop, and thereby adding less fertilizers during the season, hopefully improving profitability for the farmer by decreasing their fertilizer bill and balancing the nutrients that we have in the soil so we have healthier crops. We have multiple treatments here. That's why there's different heights of this cover crop behind me. And what we're doing is measuring how much nutrient uptake is there by this cover crop and how does that translate into crop health, crop yield, nutrient status of our crop. So in a moment, I'll take you over to one of our other research high tunnels here where you can see what the tomato crop looks like.